All right, guys, I got the special privilege of having a guest speaker for us today before the scrimmage. Okay, wanted to introduce you guys to Bobby Martin. Bobby had a great athletic career, but as you guys know, sometimes that doesn't always tell the true story about what you kind of went through and what it takes and the type of perseverance it takes to be a quality person. So, Bobby, it's all yours. Thanks so much for coming to talk to us today.
How are you, gentlemen?
Good.
First of all, thank you, Coach Turner. Again, my name is Bobby Martin, and I'll tell you a little bit about myself before I get started. I was born and raised in Atlantic City by my grandmother. I never knew my mother or father. My mom died just before I turned one, and I never knew my father. Never met him. So my grandmother raised me. I'm gonna tell you about my grandmother. She was born in 1924. Okay? She grew up during the Great Depression, Prohibition, the Roaring Twenties. She went through World War II. She grew up in an America that was quite different than it is today. We wouldn't all be sitting here in the same room today. So I come to you today with that spirit. Now, I watched you guys play last year, okay? I got a chance to follow you on Under the Lights. So my job today is I want to talk to you about not the lights that you're going to be surrounded by, but the lights you're gonna have to develop inside. Those are the only ones that count. The part of you that says, you know what, I will not give up on myself. Or the part of you that's brave enough to say, you know what, I will go and look for some help. Gentlemen, the most meaningful, the most enduring relationship you are ever gonna have in this world is gonna be the relationship you have with yourselves. Is anybody else in here hard on themselves besides me? Dude, I used to beat myself up, okay? Came out of high school, McDonald's All-American. I was set on doing that. I needed to have it. I played at the University of Pittsburgh. We had great teams. We won the Big East, all tournament, all the stuff like that. And on draft night, nobody called my name. And honestly, I drove myself crazy for not making the NBA. Now, I played in Europe, like I said, and I played on the biggest teams in the world outside of the USA. Pau Gasol, Marc Gasol, Manu Ginobili, Dirk Nowitzki, all these guys I was playing against. And in Europe, your contract isn't guaranteed. You gotta earn what you eat. So every day you gotta go out there and you gotta make your own. I hear Coach telling you that every day you have to stack a good day on top of a good day on top of a good day, right? You've heard that, okay? I'm here to tell you that every day won't be good. They can't be good. The guys went 2-what last year? 2-9, okay? Here's the thing. It's not gonna matter about wins and losses on the football field. I expect you to go out there and try to win. It's not about you working hard because that's required. I can guarantee you that your coaches in here need you to grow as young men. As young men right now, you guys are thinking, okay, I wanna bench this much. I wanna run this time in the 40. You got all physical goals, right? Well, physical goals are great, but I need you to consider your growth goals. How are you young men gonna grow up? What will you stand for? You need to talk to yourselves. Be disciplined. Keep fighting, and good luck this season. Thanks.
We'll be right back. we play the type of football we're capable of playing, Arlington Catholic should be easy. We should put them into the ground. Our JV team should play the fourth quarter. We're a good team. And I feel like we're going to surprise a lot of people. We need to gain the respect of our peers back.
Compared to like every other school, we're so much smaller. So we have a lot to prove, and it will definitely show Friday.
It is huge. I mean, we need to come out of the gates rolling to set a tone for the rest of the teams that are going to be facing us.
We've been putting in the work recently, and we just have to keep that going.
I'd definitely say, like, lock in. Like, we all need to be, like, mentally prepared. Everyone has to focus up, and I can't wait as well.
As long as we do what we're supposed to do, like, we'll sweep this team, you know?
With full energy and play four quarters, we can't go three quarters 110% and then lower it down to, like, 60 third or fourth quarter. We can't have that. We got to go all the way full.
If we start the year 1-0, it'll help us out, like, with our, like, positivity.
It's not going to be the same this year. We're going to smoke them out the water.
Off the gate, foot down, all the way. We're putting 50 up. I've talked to my boys. We're amped. We're putting 50 up. I promise you.
I won't be playing in the home opener. Did my shoulder, but I'm very nervous. I'm as nervous as I would be if I was playing.
I'm excited. I'm really excited because I've never experienced like the first home game, so I'm sure the energy is going to be even higher than I expected. So I'm just like really excited to play.
Jesus, like first game's happening soon, but sad at the same time because we're all seniors, so this is like the last first game we'll ever have like in high school football.
The more and more I want to be out there, but it's a great feeling, you know. We got a few months of football, and it's our last year, so it better be a good one.
I'm so excited for Friday, and right now I'm not nervous, but I know once Friday hits and I'm in that locker room and like the music's playing, like I will be very nervous until like pads start hitting and then everything will go away, but just the excitement is like there, like I'm ready.
It's definitely a little chilling, you know. I've been playing since I was young, you know, always opening day on Glen Road, packed to the brim, you know, hoping this Friday can be the same at the high school.
Oh my God, I think we got one of the best student sections around.
They're crazy.
I'd say electric. I'd say parents get into it. Like you hear parents like scream at the top of the lungs. You see signs going up. They get rowdy.
Generations coming here that also played, watched, coached. You know, everyone shows back up. It's a small town, but it's a really good community.
At the team dinner at Michael Lawler's house. The mac and cheese was fantastic.
And I'm a fan of the ham and cheese calzone. Great food tonight.
Yeah, real good. This is a good team dinner.
Electric, electric.
Intense game of spike ball going on. We're up 9-6 against Ali and Tiago. Ali's trying to cheat, but what can I say? We have camera footage, luckily, so we've caught him on some of his lies. Like I was saying, spike ball. Intense spike ball game. A little halftime intermission.
Hey, I forgot to
My good
say,
buddy here.
Him and Febo are veterans. Me and Tiago played like twice at the beach.
Okay, you know, just that's crazy. Excuses already before the game is ended.
Played some cornhole. They're usually pretty calm, pretty laid back. You know, good conversations with friends. A really good team bonding experience.
A lot of food. The linemen usually eat the most. At least like 2 to 3 plates. Just eat a lot of food.
Shout out to MIA. They're letting us play tomorrow and not on Saturday. So that's huge. Love it. I'm excited. Last first game.
I think we're going to get a big dub.
I think one of us is getting a pick tomorrow.
Pick six.
Pick six.
I'm not really nervous. I just wanted to come sooner.
I'm excited. It's my first time starting. I love football.
It's definitely exciting going into AC again. You know, get a little bit of revenge on AC. But yeah, I'm definitely excited.
Last first game. I mean, it's sad. I've played football since second grade. And it's the last time starting. It's So it's sad, but it's also really exciting. Finally get to go out with my boys, play on a Friday night.
We gotta play physical.
I think we should come out of the gate flying, and I think we'll be fine.
Physicality wins games, so that's what we gotta do.
Defense is looking tough, I think. We've hit.
Yeah, our defense is good.
I think we both run very similarly, so if we need to put our heads down and go, we do it. If we need to, you know, he's quick. I'll give him that. He can get around people if he needs to. So
Nick Iscone, he's gonna have a big game.
I think Gus Lambert might have a big game tomorrow.
Yeah.
First start.
I really liked running back, but Scone got the spot, and then Spence got out, so I had to fill in for him. But I'm adjusting to wing. It's fun.
I'm saying all the old linemen, this is Chuckles' first year starting on the O-line. He's showing a lot of improvement. I'd say he's probably one of the best O-linemen on the O-line. Elijah's stepped his game. Clyde stepped his game huge. I'm expecting a lot from Scone tomorrow.
I mean, I feel like I really kind of stepped into a role. But last year, I didn't see much playing time on the field, but I've always kind of had the knowledge to be there, and now I think physically I'm capable to be up with the big guys, and now my knowledge for the game has helped me to kind of make that jump and step up to the next level. There's a picture going on right now. I'm mic'd. Hi, guys.
You're mic'd up, Jeff?
Yeah.
I'm
gonna get down. I'm not gonna go like that. You're going on your tippy toes.
I can. I'm like,
buddy, what am I supposed to do?
Now a silly one.
Now you say cheese.
Team dinners, it's just a bunch of food, bunch of guys hanging out, just dudes being dudes. It's great.
Open their new season this Sunday. They'll host the Philadelphia Eagles in Foxborough.
All right, boys, good morning. Saturday, nope, it's Friday morning.
Are you no school today?
No school, game day. We're back at it again with another episode of Technical Difficulties. Yep. I'm Michael Lawler, and I'm accompanied by Christian Febo, Aliyah Bukol, and Nolan Joyce.
What's up?
How we doing?
Big question.
Shout out Christian Tilly.
Thoughts about the game tonight?
First game of the season. A lot of nerve wracking coming in here, but we'll get the job done, unlike how we did last year. So, be good.
Yo, Febo, I have a question. And you said it's really nerve wracking, but after watching film and seeing those DBs, are you really that nervous?
No. If he presses me, it's wraps. But I'm just saying, like first game jitters. But
I feel that. But like, are you gonna talk your?
I'm not a trash talker guy, but
this number four.
If I get a big play on him, I like to start talking, but only if I get big.
Like Turner said, you should be scared of the ones that don't say nothing.
Dude,
when did he say that?
So I woke up this morning. The first thing I saw pop in my phone was Beyond Podcast thing. I watched the whole thing. That's how I spent my morning. I didn't even eat breakfast.
Same here.
But hey, I watched the whole Beyond Podcast thing.
We're getting breakfast after this.
The question was, who on the team do you think is the most scary?
Who did they ask this? Coach?
Coach, Clyde, and
Scone.
And Clyde and Scone said dump, obviously.
He's a scary guy,
Coach Turner was like,
I would say dump
honestly,
as well,
He goes, honestly, I'd say Febo. Like, that kid doesn't say anything. Like, he'll make a play, just look at you, and then jog back to the huddle. This is because you should be scared of.
Well, I hate to be like Mr. Coach speak, but like, we got to take care of the ball. Just don't give them the ball for free. Don't turn it over. Hopefully try to cause a few. And a big thing in these first few games is like special teams. We've got to be clean in special teams. And just making sure we're clean in the kicking game and really just kind of take care of the ball. If we do that and if we're able to kind of run the ball, I think we're going to be able to take our shots downfield in the passing game. But for us, we're really a team that if we can run it, it's going to open up that passing game. And it's very complementary, where I think once people kind of see what kind of speed we have on the outside in terms of, you know, Febo and Hunter and Tiago and those guys, you know, if they give us one-on-one coverage, we're always going to try to take a shot and exploit that. So if we're able to run the ball and they have to bring those guys down into the box or keep one high safety because they need to commit guys to the line of scrimmage, we've got some guys that we can take some shots with, and that's what we're kind of looking to do.
The bright lights are on. I'm telling you right now, they don't respect you. 2-18s don't get respect. You go earn it every single play. No plays off.
I will not lose 8 games again. The way that you felt last year after Wakefield, that will not happen again. We'll be different.
Cuts good back job, to the Elliot. Middle, and he's going to be in the end zone for a touchdown.
Defense, 11 guys run your the ball every time. When you get there, be ready to make that happen. Simple as that. Okay, if we get 11 guys to the football on defense, we're going to be perfectly fine. They can't hang with you.
What was said during halftime?
We were very serious. We need to win this game, and right now we're not doing what it takes to win the game. We're a better team than this team. We can play better football. We can run it down their throat. They can't stop us, and we can stop them. We got to fix up a few minor mistakes, and this team's going right into the dirt.
How do you feel about tonight's win?
I feel fantastic. It feels so good to be 1-0. It's been too long.
How do you feel about tonight's win?
Honestly, last season, it was personal because we had this game in our on the calendar ready to win because last year we got blown out. And all offseason, we were getting ready just for this game because we wanted it bad.
I gotta thank my O-line. They've been blocking fantastic all night, you know. And once I get to that second level, I just put my head down and go.
Very proud of how we played in the second half, fellas. We got a lot to work on. We want to be the type of team we want to be. This wasn't good enough, right? It was a good start. It was a good start, but it's not good enough yet, right? Strive to be where we want to be. Get better every day. Hey, hell of a win. Let's go. Three. He went on three. One, two, three.